I'm here with Chromeo, P-Thug, Dave One. How's it going, guys?
Very good.
Yeah, good.
So I've heard you guys described as a lot of different styles. You know, people who I play your music to who don't know you at all. Depending on the song I play them, they're like, oh, that's a great electro band. That's a great funk band. It's like, oh, I'm really into it. How would you guys describe your sound?
I guess, I mean, electro funk is, is a good...
I can't wait to see what they're going to say on the new album.
Yeah, it's a good overarching category, but I mean, we've got, you know, obviously, you know, we've got a whole chanson dimension to what we do, because a lot of it is about the lyrics and, you know, the big choruses that the crowds sing along with. I mean, you saw in Belfort how it is. So, you know, it's not your traditional sort of rave electro thing. It's electronic and it's funk, but it's got a real strong song dimension to it.
For you, P-Thug, who's the reigning master of all time of the talk box?
Well, obviously that's Roger Troutman from Zap. The only greatest, you know, the only one that's... He basically started everything now. Teddy Riley's good, you know.
I just feel we got to shout out Stevie a lot, because he's doing, like, no, but not to take... Because he's doing all the festivals this year, which is insane.
Yeah. P-Thug, tell me a bit more about... You touched upon the sound of the next record that's apparently going to be very different. We know there's one single that's come out,
yeah.
Night by Night, which I love.
Yeah.
So what's it going to be like, the next album?
Night by Night and some more funk.
Now, you guys have a lot of those kind of ballady lover kind
of
songs.
It's big.
Is that
for
something
us.
You decided to... like adopt as your image a bit for the band or your thing, or is that really more sincere, like from the heart, like you're singing right to the ladies?
Yeah, it's both. I mean, yeah.
And does it work? I mean, have you guys ever sort of tried it on girls, kind of crooning your songs to them?
Well, we get fans who I mean, we get a lot of fans that write us and say, you know, I played for my girl, and you know, it.
Or
busy,
it's
they get busy.
Somebody not too long ago said we're using 100% as our wedding song, dance.
Yeah, we get a lot
song.
Of those. A lot.
Vous êtes rencontrés très jeune, hein, à Montréal. Vous avez quel
âge? 15 ans. Il avait 16 ans.
Et puis ça s'est fait comment la rencontre? C'était à l'école.
C'était au lycée. On avait un groupe ensemble et puis on a commencé
à travers la musique.
À travers la musique. Ouais.
Et puis le premier groupe s'appelait comment?
Ça s'appelait The Rubberdoids.
The Rubberdoid Crew.
The Rubberdoid Crew, ça veut dire quoi?
Rien,
ça
c'était genre, on voulait un nom genre qui fasse un peu extraterrestre, funky, machin.
Puis depuis, on est resté amis, le noyau est resté entre nous deux, on a changé.
On a produit du rap aussi pendant des années. J'ai même produit pour un rappeur français qui s'appelle Rossé.
Puis ça vous manque pas du tout de faire du rap?
Non. Mais moi, on écoute encore ça, mais c'est beaucoup plus stimulant de faire ce qu'on fait maintenant, parce qu'on s'exprime davantage, on chante nous-mêmes, on écrit des refrains, des chansons.
Alors ce soir, à Montreux, vous êtes sur scène avec Jamie Liddell, et puis aussi avec Janelle Monáe.
Ouais.
Vous êtes fan des essais artistes, vous les connaissez?
Jamie Liddell.
Non, mais les deux sont cool. Mais, Jamie Liddell, moi, c'est un de mes chanteurs préférés. Je trouve qu'il a une voix fantastique, donc on est très fan.
Cool. Ben, Chromeo, merci beaucoup. Comment est-ce qu'on dit au revoir dans les cinq langues là? Goodbye, au revoir.
Ah, ça c'est pas...
Français, au revoir. Anglais, see you later. Italien, ciao, arrivederci.
Cayate.
Okay, cayate, guys. Merci beaucoup. Thanks a lot.